My name is Abbie Michalik, and I work in the coal mines here on Cape Breton Island, and I had 34 years in the coal mines, and this is my 14th year as a guide. What I experienced in coal mining was a gas explosion, and which happened in 1979, but also a big fire in 1984. But I will explain the explosion I was in. In 1979, we had a buildup of methane gas, and the gas that was above the roof. While we were cutting the coal, the shear went above the coal seam and hit a piece of sandstone, ignited the fuel, which came down the wall face and it killed everybody inside. For us to be outside, what saved our lives that night was stone dust. It neutralized it in which it coal dust, and we had these trays along a level. But once this coal dust came back, the fire came out, it stopped the fire from coming out all the way through that mine. And for me to get out that mine that night, it took me an hour and 20 minutes. And when I came back to the surface, and I came down with a doctor, he's J.B. Tompkins, and while the doctor was pronouncing him dead, the only way we can identify them is with a little brass number. And that number is placed on a board before we ever go underground. And that number is taken off the board. And what numbers are still on the board will tell you that these men are still on the ground. And well, we took their lamp off with the same number on it, and the doctor wanted to know his name. And the man, he was looking in a book, and he was finding the man's name, and you put a tag number on each fella. But the man, I spent 24 hours carrying the miners out of that mine that morning, and that man of Fabe Young, which took out that morning, and came back down, and we got all the men out, and then go back into the coal mines again, which happened. And it was quite an experience to go through it. And
this is the man that you carried out?
That's the man I carried out. His name is Fabe Young. Carried out the next day out of that mine. And that was number 26 Colliery in Glace Bay here in Nova Scotia.
Abbie, the experience that you shared with us, thank you so
You're
much.
You're welcome, sir. You're welcome.
Best of luck to you.
Hi, I'm Michael Nikas. I'm sitting here in the Bank Schoolhouse in Inverness, Cape Breton Island. That quick video clip there with Abbie, our tour guide, that information wasn't provided as part of the regular tour. I had to inquire about the man whose photograph appears on the brochures and on the billboard and on the internet advertising, whose name is Michael Fabian Young. Well, as you've heard, it was a tragedy, it was an explosion. Abbie survived, Fabian Young and among others didn't survive. But what's important to us is the quality of that photograph, which was taken by a local commercial photographer, Warren Gordon. And because we are photographers ourselves, we appreciate the quality and the timing of that photograph, because that was done 2 weeks before the tragic explosion. So thank you for watching, and I hope that you share this with as many of your contacts as possible.